What is the point of life?
So what are we doing here? Why do we exist?
Good God, huh?
I have a hard time believing that we're just part of this huge moral experiment conducted by a being greater than us. Being greater than us should not give a shit about us. Well, then let's go back to the beginning. What came before?
Nothing! It's the beginning!
No, something as big as the universe doesn't just appear overnight! I mean, if there is a God, then who created God?
Are we going somewhere
yes,
here?
Yes, that's what I am asking you, Jonesy. If there's a purpose to life, we better fucking figure it out!
Okay, alright, I think I got this. Okay, go.
I'm mad at you, Dad.
Hey, dummy! I'm mad at you, too.
Did he sweep you off your feet with his extensive knowledge of vitamin water? Or what was it? His in-depth analysis of Lady Gaga that just finally reeled you in.
What are you doing?
Don't start with me.
I'm just trying to figure out what you're doing.
I'm trying to be nice.
Are you using two knives to make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich?
Take a good look at what Elias brought us. I'm gonna know everything about it in 2 hours.
Well, if it's crabs, I can't help you, buddy.
All right, guys, no. I think I need a second.
Oh, yeah, no, you know?
You want another drink?
Two brothers.
I'm not the fuck. Oh!
Give me the knife.
Peter.
I'm not gonna kill you, Vandy. Give me the knife.
Why are you acting like a jealous boyfriend all of a sudden?
I am not acting like a jealous boyfriend all of a sudden. I am calmly drinking a beer.
Fuck, look at that. Look at that. Now no one gets any fucking milk. Sick of this shit.
How do you always end up with only one sock on?
I don't know.
Well, you do it every time.
I don't know.
Well, you do it often enough for that to be a viable exaggeration.
No cash, no cat.
But it's my pookie. I want my pookie.
He's my pookie now.
I'm gonna call the cops.
No, you're not.
Oh, yes, I am.
Call the cops, I'll murder your cat right here in front of you.
You would not.
Oh, you watch. I will snap his little neck like thistleweed.
Well, scratch on this.
This one wasn't made in China. Come on, let's check it out.
The sucker uses advanced remote sensing target technology.
It didn't come with a charger, did it?
So, why you?
He's me.
Well, it ain't your looks.
Now, do you see this excess PB right here? What you do is then you take it and then you wipe it onto the other slice of bread. You see this peanut butter shit stain right here? Now, the knife is clean and ready for the J. Okay, fuckface?
Go to hell.
Really?
There's no getting through this. We've been over it. Every time that I close my eyes, I can see her bloody and bruised. And every time that I hear a siren, I can imagine her screaming, begging for her life. Every time.
We were there this morning. There was a point, and there was a reason why we did this in the first place, and that's why I want to go back.
Yeah, but there's no point.
You don't have
anymore.
The right to tell me no.
I'm not. I have a right as a boyfriend to tell you that I don't want you going back there and getting shot and killed.
Is that attitude right there why I can't talk to your mom? I wish Dad was here. Yeah, he'd understand.
He would have been extremely disappointed. You're taking the test, Alex. Don't let me down.
For you, I'm gonna cheat on the test. That's all that you give a fuck about.
You are a dependency. You are a parasite.
Well, you don't have anybody. You don't have anybody! You have me and your fucking pervert boss!
You slept with that fucking pervert boss! So what does that make you?
Emily? Why are you so quiet?
What is wrong with you?
I don't know who you are, bitch. But I know Pa's gonna want to have a long, thorough look at you.
They say that the taste of human flesh is much sweeter and softer than your normal meat. Especially when it comes to women.
That tape is the only proof that you and I had a conversation outside of that interview room. To them, I'm just a writer that Kay Connell admired. Randy is the killer. And you're a hero cop. Your life's work is intact. Another abusive scumbag is in jail. Everything is as it should be.
Vampires. Are those vampires? They're everywhere. But this is the first time I've seen them. They get you high and suck you dry.
I'm sorry, Sam. Don't follow me. People break down into two groups when they experience something lucky. Group number one, they see it as more than just luck, more than just coincidence. They see it as a sign. It's evidence that there is someone out there watching over them. And group number two, you see it as just pure luck. A happy turn of chance. It could be bad, it could be good. You know, to them it's a 50-50. But deep down they feel that whatever happens, they're on their own. And that fills them with fear.
I brought you here to escape the irrevocable damage that you intended upon yourself. Twice you have tried to take your life by your own hand. I live daily with this threat.
But there's, you know, there are a whole lot of people in the group number one. And they feel that whatever happens, there's gonna be someone there to help them. And that fills them with hope.
I met my ex for coffee.
Exit
yesterday.
My classroom, yes. Immediately, or I'll call campus.
Tube-safe gumming whore, that one. I used to spend so much time chasing after that I wanted to go back. I realized, though, that I was never in love with her. I was chasing an idea. I had myself fooled, convinced that I wanted her. And it took a stronger, much more caring person than I could ever be to exorcise that demon.
Are you the type of person who sees signs, who sees miracles? Or do you feel that people just get lucky? Or look at the question like this. Is it possible that there are no coincidences?